So here's a function move, is a class function of the class robot that I implement where I get my motion vector, and the motion vector is defined to be steering first, then distance. I have a few error checks here to make sure that the steering angle doesn't exceed the max steering angle. The same is true for distance. I want it to be non-negative. And as I go down, I now implement the motion model. So let's just look a little bit more. I make a new robot copy, as in my sample code in class. I copy all the generic parameters, length, bearing noise, steering noise, and distance noise. Nothing surprising here. Here I'll apply the noise, which you don't need it for the first implementation, but later on as we go on, you need it to actually add noise. So I'm just add Gaussian noise with the corresponding steering noise and distance noise parameters. If I set the mean of the Gaussian to be the steering command and the distance command, then this adds noise. I could have equally written steering plus random Gauss 0, comma, and then the noise parameter. And as I go down further, here's my execution of motion. My turning angle, I call it turn. This is the tangents of the noisy steering times the distance moved divided by the robot length. And as in my explanation of this question, I'm going to branch and see if my turn is significant enough. It's smaller than tolerance, and tolerance was set above to 0.001. Then I just model a straight motion. I get my new robot coordinates by the old robot coordinates moving in the orientation of the robot, cosine 4x, sinus 4y, and I increase my orientation by turn, which is likely essentially zero. In a case I go beyond zero or 2 pi, I do the modulo operation here just to make sure my angles are nicely between zero and 2 pi. The more interesting case, as we go down in this program, you can see that I now calculate the radius as distance, the noisy distance divided by turning. Then I find the center of the circle around which I'm turning using the exact same math I just gave you. I now first change the orientation to be the new orientation by adding turn to the old orientation modulo 2 pi. And then I plug the new orientation into the sine and cosine argument, multiply by radius, add to the center of the circle to get my result. So this routine over here gives me exactly what I wanted.